Hello, my name is Ricardo Carrillo Cruz, and I will be presenting automating bare metal deployment with Bifrost. So, a little bit of introduction. So, I'm a cloud automation engineer at HP. My team manages the CI platform for the HP cloud products, Helion OS, Helion Development Platform, Cloud System, CSA, a few others. Our CI is based in OpenStack Infra, which is the same toolkit that every upstream projects use in upstream. So my team had a problem at some point. We had teams requiring to run tests on bare metal. We got a bare metal lab that is now about 120 servers and it keeps growing. It was easy to manage and now it's becoming a bit of a burden. And the provisioning was a manual process, which means it's slow, it's tedious from an operator point of view, it's error prone because we have this big RAM book wiki where we would put, you know, step by step what you would need to do to provision a server. And it's not scalable because, yeah, that, I mean, this approach works for one server, but it won't work for doing deploys in tens or in 20s of them. So we gather requirements for the solution that we would put on for solve this problem. And we needed something that was easy to install, easy to operate. We needed to be easy to hook to our configuration management tool, which is Puppet. And we needed the deploys to be fast. We did not want to use the traditional method of kickstart or proceed where you're pretty much, you know, feeding a response file to the vendor installer process. So we looked at alternatives. We looked at the usual suspects, Cobbler, Foreman. They're both great products, well-known in the community, very mature. But also we looked into Aronic. And the reason why I put an exclamation mark is because Aronic is an OpenStack component. And the problem is that our lab was it wasn't a cloud, and we weren't allowed to put a compute or a neutron node. It was kind of overkill to put yet another cloud to just, you know, do deployments. So it turns out that in Aronic, you can set it up in a way that you don't need to put it in a cloud and, you know, just use it in a non-cloud environment, which is what Bifrost is all about. So the an excerpt from the Bifrost documentation. So Bifrost is a collection of Ansible playbooks where you install Aronic in a standalone mode and you enroll and deploy servers. So what a standalone means? So it means that you don't need to put Keystone. The Aronic API access can be set so you can talk to Aronic without the password, or you can also put HTTP basic authentication, but you don't need Keystone. You don't need Neutron either. You have DNS mask that provides the DHCP and the PXI service, and the static IP injection will be done via config drive. And the deployments will be performed with the AIPA, which stands for the Aronic Python Agent. It's a little Python software that is bundled in the boot image that allows the Aronic controller to talk and orchestrate and do cool things like rate setup with the bare metal servers and that kind of thing. So how it works. So obviously you clone Bifrost and you configure the global vars to set it up to your environment. You put stuff like your Aronic DB user, Aronic DB password. How do you want to build your deployment image? IP ranges, network interfaces, that kind of stuff. Then you create a bare metal inventory, which is a big JSON file, where you put all the information about the bare metal servers that you want to deploy and manage by Aronic. In each stanza for each server, you would put your MAC addresses, UUID, IPMI or ILO credentials to talk to the server, that kind of information. Then you would run the install playbook that installs Aronic in the standalone fashion that I explained in the previous slide. And it would create the deployment image with the base OS and the packages that you set up in the global vars. Then you run the enroll playbook that exposes the information that you put in the inventory, in the bare metal inventory, into Aironic. It's basically making it visible to Aironic into the Aironic database. And finally, then you run the deploy playbook. What it will do, it will create the config drives for all the bare metal servers that you will deploy with the IP information, the SSH public keys, so you can later access those servers. And finally, it will leverage the deploy mechanism of Aironic. What it does by default is it uses IPMI. So at that stage, the Aironic controller will send an IPMI command to the bare metal servers to reboot and instruct them to boot from Pixie. Then the servers will Pixie boot the boot image and load the Aironic Python agent, and the Aironic Python agent will call back the Aironic controller, saying that it's ready to receive commands. Then the Aironic controller instructs the bare metal servers to deploy the deployment image. It pulls that image to the agent, and once it's completed, then it just, you know, applies that image into the hard drive. At that point, the agent is done, so it says, it communicates back that it's done. And the controller will send yet another IPMI command to reboot. But this time, instead of rebooting via Pixie, it will be instructed to boot from hard drive. And at that stage, you have pretty much, you know, a server that is deployed with Bifrost and Aironic. And that's it. So you can find Bifrost on this URL, this Git clone. I really, you know, encourage people to contribute. It's a super cool project. A lot of cool people that are in this room doing that software. You can also find these slides on my GitHub, and you can reach me on Twitter, email, if you want to ask, you know, more details about, you know, how we really, you know, fit that into production. Thank you.